70 to 90% of women report that they need clitoral stimulation, either directly or indirectly, to reach orgasm. The clitoris is a small, highly sensitive organ located at the anterior junction of the labia minora, inner lips, above the vagina, and external urethral opening. It has four main parts: the glands, the body or shaft, the crura or legs, and the bulbs of the vestibule. The glands at the top of the vulva is the only visible part. It is about the size of a pea, ranging from a few millimeters to over a centimeter. A hood of skin covers it, called the prepuce or clitoral hood, which is analogous to the foreskin of the penis. It helps protect the clitoris glands from intense or constant friction. The clitoris extends internally, forming a structure that is significantly larger and more complex. This internal portion includes the clitoral body, which is approximately 2 to 3 centimeters long, and two cura legs that extend backward and attach to the pubic bones, and the bulbs of the vestibule. These hidden structures create a wishbone-shaped organ that wraps around the vaginal canal. The full clitoris measures about 9 to 12 centimeters in length. Rich in nerve endings, the glands alone has around 8,000 nerve endings connected to 15,000 more throughout the pelvic region, making it one of the most sensitive organs in the female body with the sole purpose of sexual pleasure. While it's a highly complex structure with far more nerve endings than the penis, it was dismissed as medically unimportant for centuries. This dismissal may stem from the fact that the clitoris does not play a direct role in reproduction. For centuries, it was considered useless, a leftover part with no real function. As a result, female pleasure has often been misunderstood or stigmatized, leading to harmful practices like female genital mutilation, FGM, which has affected more than 230 million girls and women alive today across 30 countries in Africa, the Middle East, and Asia. Female genital mutilation, FGM, comprises all procedures that involve partial or total removal of the external female genitalia. The practice has no health benefits for girls and women. It can result in severe pain and bleeding, problems urinating, and later, cysts, menstrual difficulties, infections, death, as well as complications in childbirth and an increased risk of newborn deaths. The procedure is often done without anesthesia and always without consent. The reasons why FGM is performed vary from one region to another, including being wrongly believed to reduce a woman's desire, ensuring virginity before marriage, and fidelity afterward. This is a sharp contrast to the biological truth of sexual development. In the early weeks of development, every embryo begins with the same set of genital structures, regardless of sex. After weeks 6 to 12, hormones guide these structures to take different paths. If the embryo has XY chromosomes and is exposed to testosterone, the genital tubercle becomes a penis. Without that testosterone influence, and in the presence of maternal estrogens, it becomes a clitoris. That means the clitoris and penis are homologous. They come from the same embryonic tissue and share many structural similarities. At birth, the clitoris is typically quite small. During childhood, it remains relatively consistent in size. However, with the onset of puberty and the surge of hormones like estrogen, the clitoris undergoes some growth, both in the size of the glands and the internal structures. Sexual stimuli, including physical direct touch, friction, or even indirectly through the movement of surrounding tissues, activate the parasympathetic nervous system. This activation increases blood flow to the clitoris, particularly within its internal structures. As a result, the clitoris swells and erects. The glands become more sensitive, and the entire clitoral structure becomes firmer, similar to how the penis becomes erect. The crura and bulbs press against surrounding tissues, intensifying sensation. The clitoris itself doesn't produce lubrication. However, clitoral stimulation enhances overall arousal, causing the vaginal walls and Bartholin's glands to release natural lubrication. This helps to reduce friction, avoiding injuries, and make sexual activity more comfortable and pleasurable. Some women enjoy direct clitoral contact. Others may find it too intense during high arousal. It may even retract slightly under its hood, like a protective reflex against overstimulation. Clitoral stimulation can trigger powerful orgasms and activate multiple areas of the brain. Functional MRI studies show that clitoral stimulation lights up a wide network of brain regions, including those involved in emotion, movement, memory, and bonding. Some researchers suggest that clitoral orgasms may be neurologically more intense than many male orgasms, as the stimulation engages more regions of the brain than most other types of sensory input. This full brain involvement shows that orgasm isn't just a physical release. It's a whole body, emotional, and mental experience. Just like the nose and ears keep growing, the clitoris continues to grow as a woman ages in response to hormones, especially estrogen and testosterone. The tissues can become larger and more prominent. Studies show that the clitoris can grow up to 2.5 times its original size from puberty to postmenopause. Women who have given birth may have significantly larger clitoral measurements. Some women may experience a lack of clitoral sensation, which refers to a diminished or complete absence of feeling in the clitoris during stimulation. This can interfere with sexual arousal and may make it difficult or impossible to achieve orgasm. This condition, known as clitoral numbness, can feel like a reduced response to stimulation or total insensitivity to touch. It may result from nerve damage caused by childbirth, surgery, chronic pelvic pain conditions, spinal cord injuries, certain medical conditions, medications, or physical or emotional traumas. Due to the drop in estrogen levels after menopause, several changes can occur in the clitoris. It may become less sensitive. The clitoral tissues can shrink or lose firmness, a condition known as atrophy. The glands, the visible tip, may appear smaller or retract further under the hood. Surrounding tissues may also become dry and thin, which can cause discomfort during touch or sexual activity for some women. Despite these changes, many women can still experience pleasure with proper support, such as hormone therapy, lubricants, regular stimulation, or pelvic therapy. The clitoris stays for life and doesn't shut down with age. It may just need different care post-menopause.